Hey everyone, welcome to Parrish Raceway on a lovely Friday. We're here with our 2021 KX250 bike. It won our shootout this year, got Bike of the Year honors. But as always, there's a little bit more to be had with a little bit of work. So a few months ago, our friend Jamie Ellis from Twisted Development was at our shop. We filmed the episode of the Swap Motor Live Show. And I was talking about the bike and saying, like, now that the Yamaha changed their style engine, there's no 250F with a ton of low end. And so, like the rest of the class, the KX250 lacks a little bit of low end torque, but it has amazing mid and ridiculous top end thanks to its new finger follower valve train. Anyway, Jamie volunteered to take the bike, tune it a little bit, and coax a little bit more power out of it. So, the first thing he did was disassemble the engine. Jamie poured the cylinder head. He decked the cylinder head to add some compression, which would boost the low-end power. He added a custom five-angle valve job. He plugged the bike into the dyno, and some tuners are able to get into the stock ignition. So he tuned the stock ignition to work ideally with the engine mods. He added a Vertex Piston, a Cometic gasket. The thickness of the base gasket that Jamie used is custom made for him. As is the case with everything in motocross right now, it's hard to get aftermarket exhaust. So what we did was we went with the FMF Slip On and maintained the stock header pipe. Jamie advanced the intake of the camshaft, and yeah, he's got some VP Pro 6 fuel in it. And he says on the dyno, this thing's a beast. Has a lot more low-end torque and maintain the great mid and top. The stock suspension on the bike is really great. It's KYB components front and rear. In our shootout, everybody loved the bike, but we wanted to firm it up just a little bit. Rene's about 165, 170 pounds and pro level speed, so we firmed it up a little bit for his taste. And yeah, we just wanted to build a bike that worked better than stock without breaking the bank. So we're gonna turn Rene Garcia over on the bike today to see what he thinks of it. What's up, guys? Rene Garcia here. We're out at Parrish MX on our little project build KX250. First impressions of the bike is wow. This bike is so fun to ride. It's honestly, it just reminded me of why I picked it as my shootout winner. The bike is super, super nimble, really easy to maneuver. The bike is so balanced, and with everything that we did, considering, I mean, it's really not a whole lot, it just complemented all the characteristics of this engine. Coming on, you know, we really wanted to improve the initial throttle response of the bike, give it a little bit more bottom end. Nowadays, a lot of these 250s are shooting for that more mid to top power range. So I think the guys over at Twisted Development did an awesome job for you know, stage one package. Pretty minimal stuff done. The bike has really nice throttle response, comes on real strong, and still just screams from mid to top. I mean, it's tough for me specifically. It's not necessarily my riding style, but once you get this thing to get up there in those RPMs, it shines. It pulls really, really far. And what I really like about it is that when you're in those higher RPMs, you're typically, the bike is super aggressive with, like, as soon as you let off the gas. When you're on those high RPMs, the D-cell is super strong, and it everything feels really tight. When you rev this thing out, the bike still feels really free and really light, and it really helps the handling department for sure. Enzo suspension, second to none. I mean, if you guys haven't checked them out, I highly suggest you do. The suspension right off the bat was pretty solid, and they went in there, just kind of gave us a nice setting that really helps the cornering. I noticed it a lot coming into turns. The bike just handled a lot more freer, and went through the stroke really nice, and had an awesome hold up here today at the track. We have some really nice conditions, a lot of fast guys here with some deep ruts, and I mean, it was honestly a really good day to test this bike, and you know, I'm super pumped on it. I think this is a package that can fit a wide variety of riders, whether you're just a local guy trying to get more out of your bike, or you're trying to get into some racing. You know, I definitely think you guys should check this out. All these companies are top of the line, and you get the bang for your buck for sure. So
stay tuned to Swap Moto Live for more updates. We got the 250 shootout coming out here soon, so stay tuned.